सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरौ गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Maybe since the it's open on the first page, I thought we'll look at the here also. Shri Chit Gana Ganeshaya Namo Mahiyam Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakam Nama Rupayo Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhe Drukyatya Nirmaram Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadevahan Namattonya Iti Menishchitamatihi Brahmahan Jati Guru Vedam Shukra Devam Atma Buddhya Prakasham Mumukshur Vai Sharanam Aham Prapatyam शांति शांति ही। थिंक 164 परहैप्स। ओके बिफोर वी गो ऑन टू दिस वी हैड अ क्वेश्चन। सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन आभासवाद एंड प्रतिबिंबवाद। एज मेंशन्ड practically for all practical purposes assume no differences, and if you are unless you are interested in technical details, and for that there's a lot of study needed at Tika level, but overall Abhasavada and Pratibimbavada are contrasted not with each other, they are contrasted generally, they are contrasted with Avachhedavada. So avachhedavada versus pratibimbavada can be talked about in detail. Avachhedavada versus abhasavada can be talked about in detail. However, abhasavada and pratibimbavada are so close that it is very difficult to differentiate. However, if you understand pratibimba is a jiva and abhasa is a jiva in abhasavada, then the explanation given is pratibimba is same as bimba, meaning if you use the mirror example, let's take the example of the ghata akasha rather ghata. So avachhedavada is when the total space, as in the brahma chaitanya original consciousness, we'll call it as the brahma chaitanya, that brahma chaitanya, how is it becoming a jiva? So avachhedavada says that like the boundaries of the pot divide the akasha, meaning there is no real division in akasha at all, but there is a nama rupatmaka usage, just a usage that there is ghatakasha 1, ghatakasha 2, ghatakasha 3. Similarly, is the chaitanya divided as though. Now, to contrast this, the pratibimbavada says that the bimba reflects in the, if you fill that ghata itself, you fill several ghatas with water, then you have many levels of akasha. Now you have ghatakasha and mahakasha, you also have jalakasha. How so? The jala, the water in the pot is reflecting the akasha which is there, which is mahakasha. The sky which is there, which is Mahakasha, that sky will also reflect in the water. So not only is it like Ghatakasha, but it is like Jalakasha where there is reflection. So now what is the difference between the space outside and the reflected space inside, if you compare? So the reflection of the consciousness is Jiva, and the consciousness which is there outside, the Chaitanya which is there as Mahakasha, that is being reflected. Now, what is the difference between the reflected consciousness and the original consciousness, the total consciousness? There is no difference at all. You cannot say that the Pratibimba and Bimba are disconnected. You cannot even say that when the Bimba moves, the Pratibimba does not move, or when the Pratibimba moves, the Bimba is completely different and it is isolated. In the sense that the Pratibimba is always as free as Bimba. It is not to say that the Bimba moves when the Pratibimba moves, but the Bimba is, Pratibimba is as free as Bimba. So this is the commitment of Vivaranakara. Vivaranakara says that the Jiva is not different than Brahma at all. And there is no separate Ishvara. Jiva is Ishvara. So if you look at the Ishvara, who is non-different from Nirguna Brahma, Saguna Brahma is Nirguna Brahma. There is no difference. In Vivarana, Saguna Brahma is Nirguna Brahma, which is reflected in the Antakarana, thereby gets the name Jiva, which is the Pratibimba, and there is no difference at all. So what is Moksha? Moksha is understanding that there is no difference between Pratibimba and Bimba. So Jiva is not Mithya here. The Pratibimba is not Mithya, because Pratibimba is not different at all. It has no separate existence at all. So what is Mithya there? Jiva is not Mithya. The difference between Bimba and Pratibimba, meaning Brahma or Ishvara and Jiva, is Mithya. There we do not differentiate between, we do not have to describe Ishvara separately. Ishvara is Saguna Brahma, who is not different from Nirguna Brahma. And there is a reflection now. Now, in comparison, Abhasavada says, the technical difference is that Abhasavada says, no, this Pratibimba that you talk about, there is an Abhasa. It is not reflection, it is an Abhasa. What is an Abhasa? Abhasa is a resemblance. So there is a resemblance, but it is different. So that's the difference between the two, Pratibimbavada and Abhasavada. Abhasavada says that the way you say Jiva is not different from Brahma, but here we say that Jiva is Mithya. In Abhasavada, Jiva is Mithya because there is a resemblance, but one who resembles is different. So just like if someone, Soyam Devadatta, the way you say that, but Soyam Devadatta IK is fine. That is at the IK level later. But at the Jiva level, this Devadatta that you saw elsewhere, it can be an Abhas also. It was not Devadatta at all. It was Yajnadatta, and you got confused that I saw Devadatta. Similarly, when in the example itself, when Yajnadatta, the Yajnadatta that you saw and imagined that it is Devadatta, meaning the Jiva that you are interacting in this world is an Abhasa of Brahma, different. Brahma is not affected at all, but Jiva is an Abhasa. So there is a Pratiti that Devadatta is acting, whereas Yajnadatta was acting. Yajnadatta has been different from Devadatta all the while. The issue is that you consider that Devadatta is acting, whereas Yajnadatta was acting. Once you understand that Yajnadatta is Mithya, because there is no, Devadatta did not move at all, whom you saw, that was a Bhranti, that was Abhasa. So the Yajnadatta's movement, so here Yajnadatta need not be a real entity at all. There was a Pratiti of Devadatta moving, that was an Abhasa, it was a resemblance. In fact, Devadatta was not there at all when you saw someone acting. That Abhasa was acting, that Abhasa is Mithya. In the example, we should not take it so far. Yajnadatta is a real person, as real as Devadatta. But in the exemplified, Yajnadatta is not really a person at all. It was an Abhasa of Devadatta. So it can be some kind of a misunderstanding by the cognizer that someone like Devadatta is there. We don't even know it is Yajnaratna or whoever. Was there a person also? We do not know. It is an abhasa, but it is different. So what is the moksha in abhasavada? In abhasavada, moksha is to know that this jiva is mithya. That is why there is a lot of confusion when people talk jiva is mithya versus jiva brahmaivanapara. How can it be? So in Vivarana, if you follow Vivarana, there the difference between jiva and brahma is mithya. That is moksha. Understanding that will release the Ishvara from Ishwarattam as well. Ishvara is not a creator at all. It is pure drishti srishti vada, in pratibimba vada. As long as the pratibimba is considered as different from bimba, pratibimba, jiva is considered as different from brahma, whereas one is not. I, the jiva, am, I was never different, I am not different, I will never be different from brahma, bimba. Once I understand that, then that is moksha, that will free the Ishvara as pratibimba, as bimba also, who was never bimba also, because he was consciousness, he cannot even reflect. He cannot even reflect. The jiva's freedom is freedom of Ishvara also from his Ishwarattvam. Meaning jiva's jivatvam taken away, takes away Ishvara's Ishwarattvam also, and jiva remains as Brahma, which is what Bhagavan Bhashyakara or Bhagavad Padacharya says. Shlokardena pravakshami yaduktam granthakoti vihi brahma satyam jagan mithya jivo brahma iva napara. Jiva is Brahma. So the Vivarana Sampradaya starts with jiva as Brahma, and it is eka jiva vada. There is no second jiva needed. There is no second jiva needed, and there is no second jiva possible even in pratibimba vada. Really loosely, lot of different jivas are talked about, but they are all stories. This individual jiva himself is never different from Brahma. So that is moksha in pratibimba vada. In abhasavada, it has to be understood that jiva, who being different, made, meaning mithya, different as in mithya, of course. Jiva does not have a separate existence from Brahma, but that jivatvam is not mithya, jiva himself is mithya, because he is an abhasa resembling Brahma. Brahma is not affected by whatever jiva does. Jiva is separate as abhasa, not separate as a real entity, mithya. Once you understand that this jiva is mithya, then that is freedom. Jiva is mithya, not jivatvam. So it is a technical difference, not much. And in that case, jiva being mithya, it is on individual avidya. Thereby, the individual avidya sense, the jivas can be many now. And that's where, Nana Jiva Vada can be talked about. Srishti can be talked about. Ishvara is there separately. Because Ishvara is who now? Ishvara is Maya Upadivan. Whereas jiva is Avidya Upadivan. So avidya is at an individual level, and maya is at the total level. In the pratibimba vada, you don't need that avidya and maya bheda at all. Avidya is one. Where is it? It is in Brahma, who is non-different from jiva. So avidya itself is called as maya, whereas here at the individual level there is avidya, and the same thing at the total level is called as maya. And you can have individual avidyas, many avidyas, whereas maya will be one. And that will create the reflection in maya is Ishvara, the reflection in avidya is jiva. This is abhasavada. Reflection in the sense, semblance. There is a resemblance. It is not pratibimba kind of reflection, but it is a separate mithya entity. So that is the difference between abhasavada and pratibimbavada. So coming back to our text. आत्मा सामान्यतो ज्ञातः विशेषता अज्ञातश्च. नाउ दिस इज अनदर सामग्री नीडेड फॉर एनी अध्यासा टू टेक प्लेस. यू हैव टू हैव सामान्य ज्ञान. बिफोर दैट डिड वी मिस एनी टीका? जस्ट लेट मी हैव अ लुक. No, I don't think we missed any Tika. Okay, so here, so to have Rajju's Sarpa Adhyasa, meaning Sarpa Adhyasa on Rajju, what do you need? You need Rajju Samanya Jnana, but you should miss the Vishesha Jnana of the Rajju. Meaning, in the statement, Iyam Rajju, Iyam Rajju, that Iyam Aumsha, meaning this is a robe, that Iyam Aumsha is Samanya, this. This is Samanya because in the twilight kind of a light, when there is dull light, you are able to see there is something, but you are not able to see the robe. So the Samanya Jnana of this, whatever is in the front should be there, whereas Vishesha Jnana, that it is a robe, should be missing. Then there is a possibility of Adhyasa. So in the case of the exemplified, Atma should be Samanyataha known and Visheshata unknown. Then only the Anatma Adhyasa is possible. So Atma Samanyato Jnato Visheshato Jnatascha Yattu Uktam Samanyata Jnate Visheshata Jnate Eva Vastuni Adhyaso Jayeta. This was argued as a Samagri by the Puropakshi. Samanya Vishesha Dharma Bhavat Nirvishesha Atmani Jnatatva Ajnatatva Vyapadeshaha Adhyasascha Naiva Sambhavati Iti. And since Puropakshi said that Vishesha and Samanya, which Nayayikas talk about, Samanya, Vishesha, what is there in many, but common one is Samanya, Vishesha is there in each individual members of the species. Those dharmas, Samanya Dharma, Vishesha Dharma, can be talked about. When you have a possibility of Samanya and Vishesha, Samanya, Vishesha, Dharma, Bhavat, this Nirvishesha Atma, Nirguna Brahma, cannot have Samanya or Vishesha. Samanya, for Samanya to be there, to, for you to talk about a general thing, there has to be some specific particular elsewhere. Many particulars will have a general. But Brahma is what? Ekameva Advitya. This is in your Siddhanta, says the Puropakshi. In Advaita Siddhanta, you do not have many Brahma. You don't have a second Brahma at all. Then how will you have a Samanya Dharma? Not possible. Vishesha Dharma is also not possible because Vishesha means a particular anyway. So there cannot be a particular. There is only Ekameva Advitya Brahma. You have this Vedanta Dindima. For everything you say Ekameva Advityam. So Samanya Vishesha, where do you have a perspective of Nayayikas? Where do you get it and apply it to your own Paksha? You cannot do that. Samanya Vishesha Dharma Bhavat Nirvishesha Atmani Brahmani Jnatatva Ajnatatva. Jnatatva Ajnatatva is not possible. Ramachandranji, kindly switch off your video. So Samanya Vishesha Dharma Bhavat Nirvishesha Nirguna Brahma cannot have Samanya or Vishesha. So Samanya Vishesha Dharma Bhavat Nirvishesha Atmani, you cannot have Jnatatva Ajnatatva. Jnatatva Ajnatatva Vyapadeshaha Adhyasascha Naiva Sambhavati. You cannot point out Samanya being there, Nirvishesha being there. Therefore, you cannot point out that it is known, it is unknown. Cannot have that at all. Let alone Samanya Vishesha, you cannot talk about known and unknown also. Jnatatva, Ajnatatva, Vyapadesha, that pointing out is not possible. And if it is not possible, then where will you have Adhyasa from? Adhyasascha Naiva Sambhavati. Iti Yaduktam. So, Iti Yaduktam, what was? Yattu Uktam. So, Yaduktam by the Puropakshi, Tannirasyate, that is refuted. Ayam Ahamasmi. Iti Atmastitva Anubhavaha Tavat Sarvaloka Prasiddha. So why is Samanya possible? Anubhava Siddha. If it is Anubhava Siddha, Aham Ahamasmi. I am this kind of a person. Do you say that each and every one when asked introduces oneself? You know, one may be very humble and say, you know, I am a small person. But still one will introduce oneself. Why? Because one knows. You cannot talk about someone or something you do not know. If you talk about yourself, you know yourself. Erroneously, but you know. Thereby, Ayam Aham Asmi Iti Atmastitva Anubhava Anubhava Tavas Sarvaloka Prasiddha. That is common to everyone. Each and everyone has this Anubhava of existence of one's own self. स सामान्यतः ज्ञातः आत्मा ही नाम स्वस्वरूपम एव. एंड इफ यू से आत्मा इज नॉट नोन व्हेन ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट वन सेल्फ आत्मा दैट आत्मा इज व्हाट स्वस्वरूपम वन ओन स्वरूप इज आत्मा न नाहम अस्मि इति कोऽपि प्रत्येति नो नॉट इवन अ डलर्ड विल से दैट आई एम नॉट देयर. ऑफ कोर्स देयर आर डलर्ड्स हु डू नॉट नो दैट दे आर सेइंग दैट आई एम नॉट देयर. बुद्धिस्ट Bouddhas make that statement without knowing that they are making such a statement. Very illogical statement saying that shunya, everything is shunya, meaning I do not exist. That's what they are saying. They do not realize this issue with their so-called philosophy because of not having shraddha in Vedika dharma, in Vedas, it does not bless them. That's why they do not, you know, they do not even understand the illogical statement that they make. You know, asanneva sabhavati. So one who says Brahma is not there, asanneva sabhavati. Shruti already knew that there will be such people who will say Brahma is not there. So they will become as though non-existent. They cannot become non-existent. They will as though become illogical statements. So na aham asmi iti kopi, na na aham asmi iti kopi pratyeti. Nobody says that aham नास्मि किंतु अहम अस्मि इत्येव सर्व प्रत्येति. एवरीवन मेक्स द स्टेटमेंट एंड हैज एन अनुभव. दैट्स व्हाई दे से आई एम देयर. अतः आत्मानं सद्रूपेण सामान्यतः विजानाति लोकः. देयरफॉर एवरीवन नोज, ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन नोज आत्मा. हाउ? सद्रूपेण, एज एग्जिस्टेंट. एज एग्जिस्टेंट दैट्स सफिशिएंट. दैट इज सामान्य ज्ञान. परंतु न कोऽपि प्रज्ञान घनो अखंडानंद स्वरूपो व्यापको नित्यशुद्धो नित्यमुक्तश्चाहम् इति विशेष रूपेण आत्मानं जानाति. हाउएवर नो वन नोज आत्मा इन दिस मैनर. हाउ? इट इज प्रज्ञान घन आत्मा. आत्मा मीन्स आई एम प्रज्ञान घन. आई एम अखंडानंद स्वरूप व्यापक. आई एम नित्यशुद्ध. सो प्रज्ञान घन मीनिंग I am a conscious entity without any segmentation, completely, purnataha consciousness, that's it. Nothing more than that, nothing less than that. Akhandananda Swarupa, I am of the nature of bliss. What kind of happiness, what kind of bliss, which is never segmented. I cannot become, you know, with gradations of happiness and sorrow, I cannot be associated also. All the gradations are in the antakkarana, but I am Atmas, who which has its own nature, has this blissful nature, which is Ananda, not elsewhere. Ananda is my very Swarupa. Nobody talks about in that manner. Sukhi Dukhi is possible. Sukhi Dukhi, but not Ananda Swarupa. One knows I am existent, but I am existent in this sorrowful life. Vyapakaha, I am all pervasive, no one will say, I am pervading this body. I know each and every pain in, even at the tip of my nails, if I have, not the tip of the nails, but towards the tip of the nails, if my skin hurts, I know the pain. So, anakhebhyaha, I am pervading up to the nails, but nothing beyond. I am not Vyapaka. Nobody says I am Vyapaka. No one says I am Nityashuddha. Has a bath three times if water permits, if energy permits, has a bath thrice, but still says, oh, I feel ashuddha. Still needs a bath. Nitya muktaschaham, no one says that I am ever free. Everyone is struggling for freedom in many ways, financial freedom or, you know, all sorts of freedom. There are many ideas, but I am ever free, no one makes such statements. Therefore, iti vishesha rupena atmanam na janati. Na kopi. No, na kopi vishesha rupena atmanam janati. What is the vaishishtya of atma? Nitya shuddha, nitya mukta, vyapaka, ananda swarupa, akhanda ananda swarupa, prajnana ghana. No one knows it in that manner. No one means, when we are talking about ajnanis. Jnani is already free. So here he does not have to make a statement. So the prajnana ghana akhandananda swarupa vyapaka nitya shuddha nitya mukta, this is the vishesha rupa of atma. Samanya rupa is sadrupa. Sadrupa is always known. Everyone knows one's own existence. Whereas this no one knows, the विशेष रूप नोन्नोज देयर फॉर नाउ यू हैव वॉट सामान्य यू हैव सामान्यतः ज्ञाता आत्मा एंड विशेषतः अज्ञातश्च नाउ सामग्री इज रेडी देयर बाय तस्मात् चिदानंदादि लक्षण लक्षितत्वेन विशेषतो न आत्मा विज्ञायते किंतु सामान्यतः सत्रु सत्स्वरूपेण ज्ञायते एव सो चिदानंदादि लक्षण सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप आत्मा इज विशेष सो विशेषता आत्मा न विज्ञायते हाउएवर वन नोज सत्स्वरूपेण वन नोज वन सेल्फ एज एक्जिस्टेंट बट नॉट एज सच्चिदानंद देयरफॉर सामान्य ज्ञान इज देयर विशेष ज्ञान इज देयर रिलेटिंग टू आत्मा इदंच सर्वानुभव सिद्धम ही सेज नाउ यू कैनॉट आर्ग्यू देयर देयर बिकॉज इट इज एक्सपीरियंसेबल टू एवरी वन ईच वन हैज अनुभव वन नोज बाय वन सेल्फ इफ यू आस्क समवन आर यू एक्जिस्टेंट नो वन सेज आई एम नॉट देयर सो अनुभव सिद्ध इफ यू आस्क देम आर यू चिदानंद रूप नोबडी सेज यस सो सर्वानुभव सिद्धम न चेदम केवल युक्त्या अपन्नोतुम शक्यते नाउ यू दि तार्किका और हु यूजेस तर्का एज युअर मेन प्रमाण सेज दि सिद्धांति टू दि पूर्व पक्षी यू कैनॉट यूज युक्ति एंड रिफ्यूट दिस बिकॉज वॉट इज अनुभव सिद्ध कैनॉट बी टेकन अवे बाय युक्ति युक्ति इज नॉट अ प्रमाण विच कैन काउंटर अनुभव अनुभव इज ज्ञान इट इज प्रमा अनलेस यू शो इट एज भ्रमा इट स्टैंड इट रिमेन्स एज प्रमा Now, how will you show, if you argue that I will use logic to establish that it is wrong, it is not Anubhava, Anubhava is not Prama. If you want to do that, then your Yukti is not capable to do that because Yukti has dependence on Anubhava, meaning on Pratyaksha. So, it has its basis in Pratyaksha. Yukti is not sufficient to take away Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha will remain. पामरादि सर्वसाधारण्येन भासमानं सद्रूपं आत्मानः सामान्य स्वरूपम् इत्युच्यते सो व्हाट इज सामान्य स्वरूप इवन अ डलर्ड नोज सर्वसाधारण्येन पामर इज अ डलर्ड इवन अ डलर्ड नोज हाउ दिस आत्मा शाइन्स फोर्थ एज एग्जिस्टेंट दैट इज द सामान्य स्वरूप यू डोंट हैव टू बी ब्रिलियंट एंड यू नो यू डोंट हैव टू बी अ पंडिता टू नो यू नीड यू हैव टू बी अ पंडिता टू नो द विशेष बट सामान्य इवन अ डलर्ड नोस केवल ब्रह्मानुभव सिद्धि चिदानंदादि स्वरूपम तो विशेष रूपम एंड दिस विशेष रूप इज केवल ब्रह्म विदाउट केवल ब्रह्म मीन्स ऑलवेज इट इज केवल ब्रह्म बट ड्यू टू अज्ञान देर इज मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट आई एम दिस आई गो अहेड एंड से आई एम बियॉन्ड द आई से दैट आई एम दिस और दैट I am a man, I am a woman, and son of this person, daughter of that, father, mother, all these statements are not kevala brahma. They show the misunderstanding that I do not have this vishesha rupa jnana, which is kaivalya. Kaivalya is my vishesha rupa. Vishesha is not the body really. Vishesha is knowledge that I am free from the body mind sense complex so kevala brahma anubhava siddhi chidanandadi swarupam tu vishesha rupam this kaivalya anubhava anubhava there is aparoksha jnana you have seen earlier also it is through vritti of course but still vritti fades away you don't need anything after that it takes away ajnana and that is called as sakshatkara or anubhava of Brahma, but it is not objectifiable. It is without any, because there are no tools remaining, no instruments remaining to objectify. Indriyas cannot objectify, Antakkarana cannot objectify, Vritti cannot objectify, because the objectifier who uses the Vritti cannot use it to objectify himself. The objectifier remains as Kevala Brahma once the Vritti takes away Ajnana. So Kaivalyam is also another way to say sakshatkara that is vishesha roopa of brahma which is my swarupa adhika desha kalavarti yat tat samanya swarupam iti nyuna desha kalavarti yat tat vishesha swarupam iti cha laukika padarthanam vivekah now what is the samanya and vishesha if you inquire into it then samanya is that which is adhika desha deshakavarti मीनिंग दैट विच हैज मोर स्प्रेड इज कॉल्ड एज सामान्य. वॉट इज लिमिटेड मीनिंग वॉट इज डज नॉट हैव अ मोर स्प्रेड इज कॉल्ड एज न्यून देश कालवर्ती. सो विच डज नॉट हैव मोर स्प्रेड इन देश एंड काल इज कॉल्ड एज विशेष. एंड वॉट हैज मोर स्प्रेड इन देश काल इज कॉल्ड एज सामान्य. दिस इज वॉट दिस इज लौकिक दृष्टि इन लौकिक पदार्थ वी नो दिस दिस इज अ विवेक. दिस इज हाउ वी अंडरस्टैंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन सामान्य एंड विशेष. सामान्य इज देर इन मोर प्लेसेस एंड अक्रॉस टाइम वेर एज विशेष इज इन लेसर स्पेस एंड टाइम लेस प्लेसेस एंड टाइम. सो दिस इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग. नाउ यू अप्लाइड टू दी कॉन्टेक्स्ट चिदानंदयोः अपि चिद एंड आनंद चिदानंदयोः अपि आत्मन स्वरूपत्वादेव सद्रूपवत् चिदानंद स्वरूपम अपि व्यापकम एव वर्तते. नाउ दिस चित एंड आनंद चिदानंदयोः अपि आत्मन स्वरूपत्वाद् चित एंड आनंद बीइंग आत्मस्वरूप. नाउ यू हैव सच्चिद एंड आनंद यू हैव थ्री इन लक्षण वाक्य यू विल हैव यू नो सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम और एल्सवेयर यू नो सच्चित आनंद. Now, if you take Satchit Ananda, Sat is known, okay? Chit and Ananda is comparatively not known. Ananda is very difficult to know. Chit may be known when one is taught. Ananda, even after being taught, people have difficulty to understand. We'll let that be and we'll go with the text which says that Sat is very easy. If you ask someone, are you there? One says yes. No one will say no. If you ask, are you conscious? One may say yes, but are you conscious entity? One may question, oh, I am going to die. Can I be a conscious entity? In Sushupti, I do not know that whether I was there or not. So one needs teaching. One needs to be taught whether you were really existent. Some people have a misunderstanding that in Sushupti, I wasn't there. So their Chaitanya is not easily seen in Sushupti. Sadrupa also. I mean, Chaitanya, Sadrupa, if you say that, were you there in Sushupti? There, if you just tell him, I mean, you woke up the same person that you slept, then Sat is very easy to understand. Yes, I am the same person. There is Pratyabhijna. I am the same person who slept yesterday night, who woke up this morning. Thereby, Sadrupa, one may not have an issue to understand. However, Chaitanya, were you existent? Yes, in sleep. Yes, I was there because of this Pratyabhijna. I am the same person. But was I there? No, I am conscious now. Yesterday night I was conscious. But in deep sleep, I do not know. Was I conscious? No, I was not conscious. I slept like a log. So Chit Swarupa is difficult. Further difficult is, oh, Ananda. In waking itself, I don't have Ananda. In Swapna, I have nightmares. And in deep sleep, I do not know Ananda. I have to infer when someone teaches me. So, Ananda is more difficult. So, Chidananda yohapi atmana swarupatvad eva sadrupavat Chidananda swarupam api vyapakam eva vartate. But what is the reality? Shruti says that Satchidananda Brahma. Therefore, the way Sat is vyapaka, Chit and Ananda also vyapaka. As vyapaka as Sat, Chit and Ananda, or as vyapaka, as pervasive as Sat. अतः एव आत्मन सत्तापेक्षया आनंदादिकं व्याप्यम् इति वा आनंदाद्यपेक्षया सत्ता व्यापिनी इति वा न शक्यते वक्तुम्. नाउ यू कैन नॉट से दैट वन इज मोर परवेसिव देन द अदर मीनिंग सत इज मोर परवेसिव. अतएव आत्मन सत्तापेक्षया कंपेयर्ड टू सत आनंदादिकं व्याप्यम् इति वा आनंदाद्यपेक्षा सत्ता व्यापिनी इति वा. यू कैन नॉट मेक अ कंपैरिजन बिटवीन दीज टू एज विच इज मोर pervasive, which is less pervasive among Sat, Chit and Ananda. Even if it is difficult to understand, Shruti says all are Lakshanas of Brahma. They are not Visheshana. They are not Vyavartaka Visheshanas. They are Lakshana Visheshanas, meaning they just define Brahma. They are not qualities of Brahma. They are not Visheshanas of Brahma, which divide one Brahma from other, etc. Therefore, all are equally pervasive defining words. So satta, chitta and ananda is all equally pervasive. Tathacha आत्मन सद्रूपम सामान्यम चिदानंद रूपम विशेष रूपम इति यद्यपि न संगच्छते देयरफॉर ऑल्दो सो ही इज मेकिंग अ बैकग्राउंड ही इज बिल्डिंग अ फाउंडेशन फॉर व्हाट ही इज गोइंग टू से एंड व्हाट इज ही गोइंग टू से इज बेस्ड ऑन दिस अधिक देश कालवर्ती सामान्य एंड न्यून देश कालवर्ती विशेषा दिस इज लौकिक पदार्थानां विवेक सो ही हैज टू एक्सप्लेन द वे पीपल अंडरस्टैंड पीपल ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज मोर परवेसिव इज सामान्य व्हाट इज लेस परवेसिव इज विशेष सो नाउ ऑल्दो ही कैनॉट से सत इज व्हाट इज मोर परवेसिव एंड चित इज लेस परवेसिव एंड देयर बाय ही कैनॉट से दैट सामान्य इज सत्ता विच इज नोन एंड विशेष इज चित्त एंड आनंद विच इज नॉट नोन स्टिल व्हाट तथा च आत्मन सद्रूपम सामान्यम चिदानंद रूपम विशेष रूपम इति यद्यपि न संगच्छते even if it cannot be valid because all are equally pervasive tathapi atmana satta swarupasya pratitihi sarvaloka sadharanyena avidyadashayamapi jayate na evam chidananda swarupa pratitihi avidyadashayam sarvesham jayate however even if it is true that they cannot be said to be different and you cannot say one is more vyapaka than the other and satta is samanya whereas the chitta ananda is vishesha still he says what happens is that this much you have to accept that tathapi atmana satta swarupasya pratiti that I am existent sarva loka sadharanyena avidya dashayam api jayate even if you do not have jnana meaning atma jnana even if one is an ajnani Still one has satta swarupa pratiti. If you ask one person, are you existent? Yes. Even in avidya dasha, even when ajnana is there, one knows one is existent. Thereby we can make a differentiation and counter with chitta ananda. Naivam chidananda swarupa pratiti avidya dashayam sarvesham jayate. In avidya dasha, not everyone understands chitta ananda. One has to be taught more for chitta. One has to be taught a lot for ananda, and still one may not accept that I am ananda. So much of dukkha, what ananda? And especially when there is dukkha, you go and tell someone at your own risk that you are ananda swarupa. Somebody is crying, so much of dukkha, lot of adversity the person is facing, and then this, Paramananda Shishya, as someone would say, who is studying Vedanta, says that I need to go and help someone out, goes and says that you are Ananda Swarupa. I mean, he can say that at his own risk. Not possible to face Ananda in such Dukkha. So not everyone knows it. Even after teaching, one will not be able to agree to that easily. Takes a lot of time. चिदानंद स्वरूप प्रतीति अविद्यादशायां नैव सर्वेषां जायते न एवं न एवं न जायते इन दिस मैनर हाउ एवं एवं इन विच मैनर एवं कथम हियर दिस सत्ता प्रतीति सत्ता स्वरूपस्य प्रतीतिवत इति एवं सर्वेषां चिदानंद स्वरूप प्रतीतिः अविद्यादशायां न जायते केवलम चिन्मात्र निष्ठानाम ज्ञानीनाम तो सदा सर्वांश प्रतीति रस्ति हाउएवर दोज हु हैव कैवल्य दिस ज्ञानीज हु हैव कैवल्य सिद्धि केवलम चिन्मात्र निष्ठानाम ज्ञानीनाम दोज ज्ञानीज हु हैव निष्ठा इन दिस चित्त चित्त स्वरूप आत्मा चिन्मात्र एंड केवल नथिंग एल्स ओनली इन चित्त नॉट इन चित्त एंड सम जड़ा ऑल्सो मिक्सड अप Oh, it's okay. I mean, I understand. One who has nishtha, understanding, but has culmination in nishtha, does not give in to any dehadi vrittis. To sada sarvamsha pratiti asti. Amshas are what? These amshas are not parts. They are lakshanas. Satchit and ananda, all three are clearly known and one has nishtha. One knows that I am Satsurupa, Chitsurupa, Ananda Surupa. Those kind of jnanis do not miss it. So here, Prachanda Tippanakara says, in relation to what? आई मिस दैट टिप्पणम. यू हैव सीन दिस. ओके एनीवे जस्ट लेट मी गो थ्रू इट. प्रचंड प्रकाश सूर्य तमोवत स्वयं प्रकाश आत्मचैतन्य अज्ञान संसर्ग कथम घटेते इति आक्षेपो न युक्त विषम दृष्टांत. वी हैव सीन दिस. सो वी हैव सीन दिस विषम दृष्टांत. फर्दर सर्वांश प्रतीति अस्ति ज्ञानीनां चिन्मात्र निष्ठानां दे हैव दी प्रतीति ऑफ ऑल अंशास. Difficult to scroll pages here. Where were we? 62 itself. Okay. Just look at a little and then stop. So यद्यपि अविद्यादशायां चैतन्यानंद स्वरूपम अपि आस्ते एव. यद्यपि अविद्यादशां चैतन्य आनंद स्वरूपमपि आस्तेव तथापि अविद्यया न तत् प्रतीयते इति अविद्यमानवत् कृत्वा चैतन्य आनंद स्वरूपं परिच्छिन्न देशकालवर्ति सत्ता स्वरूपं सकल देशकालवर्ति इति च उच्यते. सो ऑल्दो यू कैनॉट सेपरेट देम एंड कॉल वन एज सामान्य एंड अदर टू एज विशेष मीनिंग सत्ता एज सामान्य एंड चित्त एंड आनंद एज विशेष स्टिल अविद्यादशायां प्रतीति टेकिंग प्रतीति ऑफ सत्ता एंड नॉट ऑफ चित्त एंड आनंद वी कैन इन दैट अविद्यादशा इट्सेल्फ वी कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस तथापि अविद्यया न तत् प्रतीयते. चैतन्य एंड आनंद स्वरूप इज नॉट क्लियरली नोन इति अविद्यमानवत् कृत्वा देयरफॉर यू नो taking it as though in avidya dasha one does not have that knowledge. So avidya avidyamanavat krutva meaning as though non existent chaitanya ananda since pratiti is not there laukika understanding is what whatever yadna pratiyate nasti whatever is not there is not there whatever is not having an appearance is not there. I don't feel it. I don't think I am ananda swarupa. So what ananda? It is not there. I don't think that I am Chaitanya Swarupa, ever Chaitanya Swarupa. Chaitanya is there, it comes and goes. I mean, in deep sleep, it is not there. So it is not there. It is having less Kala and less Desha. Ananda also comes and goes. You know, very little Ananda. Sometimes in some Vastu, there is Ananda. In some Vastu Vishayas, there is no Ananda. So less Desha and comes and goes. So less Kala compared to Satta. Satta is there. But Ananda comes and goes. Satta is there, but Chaitanya comes and goes. Therefore, if this avidya manavat krutva, as though non-existent, making it Chaitanya Ananda Swarupam Parichinna Desha Kalavarti and Satta Swarupam Sakala Desha Kalavarti Chauchyate. So we can say now that Satta is ever there, but Chaitanya and Ananda comes and goes for Najnani. Thereby, परमार्थत देयरफॉर यू गॉट सामान्य इन सकल देश कालवर्ती सत्ता एंड विशेष इन परिच्छिन्न देश कालवर्ती चैतन्य एंड आनंद. परमार्थत नैवास्ति सामान्य विशेष भावः सच्चिदानंद स्वरूपस्य आत्मनः. बट ही इज क्लैरिफाइंग इन रियलिटी वी आर नॉट सेइंग दैट दी सत्ता इज सामान्य एंड चैतन्य एंड आनंद चिद एंड आनंद आर विशेष. We are just putting it as an argument from the Vyavaharika Drishti. In Paramartha Drishti, there is no difference between the three. There are no three really. There is one entity which is having the definition of Satchidananda. Avidvat Pratityanusarena tu Sakalpyate. It is imagined, you know, taking an Ajnani, it is imagined as to what is his state. From his perspective, what would it be? Satta is there, always there. And everywhere, but this chit and ananda comes and goes. It is not there everywhere, and it is not there all the time. Atma nirvishesha ityasya siddhantasya na kapi anupapatti hi anena. So with this paramartha and vyavaharika, meaning paramarthika and vyavaharika differentiation made, if we have some kalpana in vyavaharika, that does not change the Atma being Nirvishesha. We can bring in the Samanya and Vishesha in the Paramartha Drishti, it is nirvishesha, but in the parmarth, in the vyavaharika drishti, we can bring in these arguments and establish that one is samanya, other is vishesha. Siddhanta is not changed. So if you say that your siddhanta is, so yes, our siddhanta remains so, because we can, in fact, Advaitin can get away by saying anything and everything by the difference in realities. Anything and everything means, for in argumentation, we can say the same thing that the Purvapakshi has said while refuting the Purvapakshi statement. Why? Because Purvapakshi says it is real. We say it is not real. I agree with everything that you say as unreal, and we can make the same statement. But if you say it is wrong, it is not vitanda, but if you say it is wrong because you say it is real, we have another perspective, vyavaharika satta. There we can make all arguments of the Purvapakshi also and say that it is valid in vyavahara, not in paramartha. Yadi atmanaha samanya vishesha bhava paramarthika abhyupagamyeta tada atma nirvishesha ityadi vedanta siddhanto badhyeta eva. If we had said that in paramartha also there is samanya and vishesha differentiation, satta and is different from chit and ananda rupa, then you can make an aropa that we are compromising our siddhanta. You are, you know, going against atma nirvishesha. We are not making such compromises. Parantu naiva tatha abhyupagamyate. We do not accept any difference in paramartha, but in vyavahara, we accept all sorts of bhedas. You can talk about anything and we'll agree. As long as it is valid in vyavahara, you can say anubhava siddha, we'll say yes, anubhava siddha. But in paramartha, we do not make such differentiation. Kintu samanya vishesha bhava, bhava vani va vidyaya, not sure what this is, samanya vishesha bhava, aniva vidyaya atmana. So basically bringing these samanya and vishesha bhavas, kintu, on the other hand, what are we doing? Samanya and vishesha bhava we bring in avidyaya. Due to avidya we bring in, that gives you vyavaharika satta, and now you can talk about bhedas. Avidyaya atmanaha vibhavyamanatvad. Only due to that reason we, the samanya and vishesha shine forth as though vibhavyamanatvad. Ajnyajana bodhartham, for the ajnanis, for them to understand, for their understanding, samanya vishesha vyavahara kalpyate. There is an arrangement made just to reveal your atma being nirvishesha. We need vishesha. Vishesha is brought in not so adhyaropa para apavadabhyam nishprapancham prapanchate. Adhyaropa is done from the vyavahara drishti, apavada is done from the paramarthika drishti. Nothing sticks, none of the apavada stick, adhyaropita sticks to the paramartha brahma. Paramartha brahma, nothing will stick. It is all kalpana made for teaching. Ittham, so ittham satta rupa samanya swarupena vidite nitya shuddha buddha mukta khanda chidananda adi advitiya brahmatmana cha avidite atmani bandhadhyas sambhavatyeva. And thereby samanya rupa being known as satta rupa, satta swarupa is known, whereas chitta and ananda is not known. Chitta and anandata is not known. And what else is there? So he puts in all that with chitta. He says nitya shuddha buddha mukta akhanda chidananda advitiya brahmatmana cha avidite, avidite sati. So you have satta swarupa samanya swarupena vidite sati. Then nitya shuddha buddha mukta khanda chidananda advitiya brahmatmana cha avidite sati. What is that? Atmani. In that, in atma is not known. In vishesha rupa and samanya rupa it is known. Bandhadhyasa sambhavatyeva. So samagri is there and it can, this adhyasa is possible. Adhyasikasya cha bandasya jnanat nivritti rupa yujyateva atayeva grantasya prayojanamapi sambhavatyeva. So having talked about the last samagri, now he says adhyasikasya cha bandasya. This bandha is possible as an adhyasa because you have samagri of samanya jnana being there, vishesha jnana being not there. So samanya jnana and vishesha jnana being there. यू कैन हैव अध्यासा एंड अध्यासा व्हाट दिस अनात्मा अहंकार आदि देहांत बंध इज अध्यस्त नाउ एंड दिस आध्यासिकस्य च बंधस्य दिस बंध विच इज आध्यासिक सुपर इम्पोज दैट विल गो अवे बाय ज्ञान इट विल गो अवे ओनली बाय ज्ञान नीदर कर्म नॉर उपासना योगा नथिंग विल टेक इट अवे ओनली ज्ञान ज्ञान ज्ञानात् निवृत्तिरपि युज्यते एव एक्चुअली ज्ञानादेव निवृत्ति युज्यते दिस एवकार कैन बी ब्रॉट इन हियर आल्सो ज्ञानात् एव निवृत्ति युज्यते अत एव ग्रंथस्य प्रयोजनमपि संभवत्येव देयरफॉर ग्रंथ हैज अ प्रयोजन एंड ग्रंथ आरंभ कर्तव्यः दिस इज हाउ दि सिद्धांत हैज क्लोज इन दि नेक्स्ट सेट ऑफ आवर्तस ही विल टॉक अबाउट The Purvapakshi may say now that, okay, let's say Jnanat Nivritti Sambhavati, meaning Jnanat Nivritti Rapi Yujyate Eva, Karmana Api Sambhavati. By karma also it is possible. Now, why will I pick up Jnana, so much of effort and Shravana Mana Nidhyasana needed, Vivekadi Chatushtaya, this Shatka Sampatti, all this find a guru, study, do Manana, do Nididhyasana. All this is not needed. I am happy to do karma, which I have already been doing since my birth. And since my Upanayana, I have been following this dharma. I just need to continue that and I'll get moksha. Why will I do this? So that has to be refuted. If karma can give you moksha, jnana is not needed. But that's why jnanat nivrittir api yujyate eva, jnanat eva nivrittihi. So that has to be established for the Purva Pakshi. So karmana mokshana siddhyati has to be shown. That we look at in the नेक्स्ट पाठ सत्यम ज्ञानम सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धि दृक्यत्व निर्मलम अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्यक परम महः तदेव अहम् नमत्तोन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः सो एनी क्वेश्चंस कैन सी इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ नमस्ते
हरिओम.